Type 2 diabetes is one of the oldest known ailments. The Indian healer Sushruta described it in the 5th century BC as madhumeha or honey-like urine when he noticed that urine from sick people attracted ants. More than 1,000 years later, we've come a long way in our understanding of the disease. At the heart of type 2 diabetes lie tiny blobs of cells called islets. These blobs are scattered all over the pancreas, an organ in our abdomen, and produce hormones which help our body to process sugar. The most important of these hormones is insulin, and if we don't have enough insulin, the blood sugar slowly causes damage to many organs, eventually leading to death. With the discovery of insulin and insulin therapy 100 years ago, what was earlier a disease with a death sentence became a condition we can live with. So how do we learn about type 2 diabetes? My name is Dr. Daniela Nasteska, and I'm a researcher at the Oxford Center for Diabetes, Endocrinology and Metabolism. Together with Professor David Hodson's lab, we study all things islets, those little cell blobs in the pancreas.
For example, we study what their cells look like, how different they are from each other, how they talk to each other, and what can go wrong, as in type 2 diabetes. In order to regulate blood sugar, islet cells produce many special types of proteins. By observing, measuring, and mapping these different proteins, we can study what is happening in an islet when it is healthy and when it is not. Our work is beautifully visual. We observe all these different proteins by coloring them in fluorescent green, blue, orange, and shades of red. We then take pictures of them using powerful microscopes.
We look at the shapes of the proteins, how much there is of each, where they are located, and how all of this links to type 2 diabetes.
The whole thing feels a bit like doing a jigsaw puzzle, but we have to find the pieces first. Coloring the proteins allows us to find them and begin solving the puzzle.
We get excited over each new piece we find, and the islet story makes more sense every time we add a new piece.
As technology improves, so does our puzzle. It gets more detailed and with better resolution.
Taking many islet pictures over time helps us create videos of the islets in action, and thus tells us a story about what is happening inside the body.
We can see and measure how the cells within islets talk to each other and respond to food signals based on how much and when the fluorescent colors change. And just like in the movies, the videos can show unexpected twists and turns, making the story more interesting and binge-worthy. Similar to a viewing algorithm on Netflix curating content based on our watch history, our islet videos inspire us to ask more questions and edit future content based on what we've learned so far. The overarching story of type 2 diabetes research is one of many puzzles. By comparing the ones we've built of healthy islets with the ones showing signs of diabetes, we learn how to fix the islets and find new therapies. It is not an easy task, but it isn't a lonely one. In a super connected world like ours today, whenever we're missing a piece, we find it in other labs' puzzles. Modern science is not an exclusive club. We keep our doors and hearts open to new knowledge and to everyone keen to work with us or join us.